Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to do some discount problems, and these are the two problems we do on this video. We're going to work with discount problems. They're very similar to markup problems, except that we have a selling price of something and we're going to mark down. There's going to be some sort of a discount. So in discount problems, it's really a percent decrease type of problem. You're decreasing the price and it's based on what the selling price was, like 10% off, 20% off. And the terms we usually see are discount rate or markdown rate. So when you see discount rate or markdown rate, we're referring to the percent of the discount on the original price. Now, the amount of money an item is reduced by is called the discount or the markdown. So when it talks about what's your discount, it means how much money did you actually save? So let's do this discount problem. A $425 dresser set is on sale for 35% off the regular price. So we're assuming that is the regular price here. Find the sale price. Okay, there are a couple ways you could do this, but a common way is to simply take the 35% off of the regular price. So that would be your discount, how much you get a take off. So we would have to do 35% of 425 to figure that out, which is 0.35 times 425. Now, in terms of money, of course, it's going to be dollars and cents. So you can either get a calculator out to figure this one, or you can do multiplication on a piece of paper. And this comes out to this much money, 148.75. Pretty good. Now, the one thing I'm going to do before going on is seeing if this seems like a reasonable amount. 35% is about a third. Okay? Right? It's a little more than a third. So the question is $148.75, is that about approximately a third of $425? And of course, a lot of people have trouble taking a third of $425, but you could sort of just estimate it, think of the 148.75 as about $150. Okay, so if I multiply by 3, right, I should get the whole price. That would be 450, but it was really 425. So it looks like it's in the ballpark, so that's important. See if it's in the ballpark. So the discount, $148.75. Now, what it's asking us for is the sale price. So how do you get the sale price? You have to subtract that from the regular price. So the sale price would be the original price of the dresser, $425, right? Minus, I'm going to put it in dollars and cents, $148.75. And now you just do that arithmetic. You could do that on your scratch paper if you'd like. I'm not going to take up the space here. But that comes out to $276.25. So that is the sale price for that dresser. So it's a pretty good discount, right? Almost $150 off. Of course, this is not a cheap set, obviously, in the first place. Okay, what's another way? I said there was another way of doing it. If you want to get the sale price, you could think of it this way, if you want to get it directly. If it's 35% off, then you're still paying 65% of the original dresser set price, right? Because I got that by subtracting 35 from 100 or saying 35 plus what is 100. So another way to get the sale price, a direct way, I often do this so I don't have to do two steps, is I just want to do 65% of the 425. So I only have to pay 65% of that $425, right? Because I don't have to pay the other 35% because I get that's how much off. So now that's 0.65 times 425, and same thing, you either want to do that multiplication or put it into your calculator, which I'm doing right now as I'm speaking, and I get on my calculator 276.25, same answer. So no matter how you do it, you should get that the sale price is $276.25. So here's our next problem. A $310 bicycle is on sale for $248. What is the discount rate? All right, so we're looking for the percent this time, right? And we need to know what the markdown was, because when we want to remember the discount rate is the same thing as the percent decrease. So the percent decrease, which is the same thing as the discount rate, right? Another word for that. That's the same thing as the decrease amount, how much it was decreased by, right? Over the original amount. And I'm not given that decrease amount. I know the original amount. It was a $310 bicycle, right? So I'm looking for a percent here. And I know the original amount. I need to find the decrease amount. In other words, how much off was it in terms of money? All we need to do is subtract. 310 minus 248. I think that's 62. So it was decreased by $62. Be careful that you don't put 248 in the numerator. Okay? And then we need to change this to a percent. So I could reduce first and then multiply by 100%. I'm going to go ahead and just multiply by 100% first. All right, so if I multiply by 100%, now you can get out a calculator and do this, but it's actually pretty easy to do without a calculator. If I divide the top and bottom by 10, that takes away both of those zeros. And now I've got 62 divided by 31. Did you notice that's just 2 times that 10%? So that's what we're looking for. The discount rate is 20%. So this was a 20% off sale, and now let's just check it. Check. What is 20% of 310? Okay, so what's 20% of 310? Well, it's 0.2 times 310, which is $62, which is how much it was decreased by, right? We took the 310 minus 62, we get the 248. And do you remember another way to figure out what 20% of 310 is? You could say, well, 10% off would just be $31, so 20% off would be twice that, 2 times 31, 62. So again, you sort of could check it out. Different ways of thinking about it, but in the end, make sure you go back and use your common sense and see if that all makes sense. So this was a 20% off sale. That's what it was asking. When it says, what is the discount rate? Remember to write your answer with a percent sign.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.